كلمة بيزا
يعملت عن
what it means.
هي تسأل عن ما معنى كلمة مرزا.
نعم. مرزا is mir is a title which means somebody who is highly respectable and who has authority. So the word mir means someone like a prince or a qadi or somebody with big authority is called mir. So all the family members of the early Mongolian people who conquered India were given this title, mir, and their children, sons, princes were called mirza. Because it was there, in fact, Mirzadeh, the son of Mir. So like Shah and Shahzadeh in Persian, so this was Mir and Mirzadeh. So originally this has the, what would you say, how the reason of this nomenclature, this. Why this name was given is what meaning it has, what principle was involved in this is simply this. So Mirza could not only apply to Mughals, it could apply also to all the people who held authority, who were great in the areas, so they were called Mirs. And their family and the princes were called Mirzadeh. So it became shortened into Mirza. Hazrat Masih Maud has claimed that this word Mirza, though commonly understood to mean Mughals, is not necessarily a title of the Mughals. So maybe our family which came from Persia had originally come from those lands where Mughals were predominantly the settlers. Mughals lived predominantly. He said, it is not essential that we were Mughals. But one thing is certain, that before coming to India, we had remained in Persia for about 300 or some years. So we have a better title to be called Persians rather than Mughals. Right?
السؤال هو عن معنى كلمة مرزا. وقد بيّن أمير المؤمنين أنها أصلها مير، وكلمة مير هي لقب يعطى للشخص المحترم، الشخص ذو المكانة، الشخص الذي يتبوأ سلطة وله نفوذ في مكان ما. وكانت الإمبراطورية المغولية التي غزت الهند أغدقت هذا اللقب على أمرائها وقادتها وحكام هذه المنطقة، وأبنائهم أخذوا هذا اللقب فصار ميرزادة، أي ابن المير أو ابن الأمير أو ابن الحاكم أو ابن السلطان مثل هذا، ثم اختصرت بعد ذلك إلى ميرزا. يقول أمير المؤمنين أن المسيح الموعود بيّن أننا أخذنا هذا الاسم ليس بالضرورة لأننا من المغول، ولكننا مكثنا في فارس لأكثر من 300 سنة، وهذه المناطق كان يسيطر عليها أو دخلها المغول، وربما هذا الاسم تسرب أو دخل إلينا من هذا الأثر المغولي، ولكننا فرس أكثر مننا من المغول.
You know the word beer is also in Persian poetry is also used to indicate God. In one of the famous verses of eulogy of Hazrat Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, it's a very popular Persian verse poem. It says, "Khuda khud mere majlis bood." The word, one word is doubtful, I'm not sure, but I'll put something in instead. Khuda khud mere majlis bood dar jahi ke man boodam. Which word hai wahan? The literal translation is, God was himself the Mir of the Anjuman, the society, the congregation. At that place, which I am talking about, where I was, I saw it. Muhammad Shami Majlispood. Again, I'll say Darjai because I don't remember the original words. Yaman Budam. Muhammad was the light lamp of that congregation. The night which I'm talking about, the vision which I saw, it was God who was Mir and Muhammad Rasulullah was the light or lamp of that Nurullah. That is the name. So the word Mir is applied also to God, also to Hazrat Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Many a poet has referred to him as Mir. Not Amir-e-Shariat, but Mir-e-Karwan, the one who is the leader of the caravan.
Qaid.
Yes, yes. This is the word.
يوضح أمير مؤمن أيضا أن كلمة مير في اللغة الفارسية استخدمت في بعض الأبيات الشعرية التي تتحدث عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. يقول الشاعر, أنتم سمعتم بيت الشعر وهو صعب علي, ولكن البيت يقول أن الله هو مير هذه الجماعة, هو رأى في الرؤيا أن الله هو رئيس سيد هذه الجماعة, وأن محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم كان المصباح أو النور الذي يضيء هذا الليل. فكلمة مير بمعنى سيد تستخدم أحيانا بالنسبة لله تعالى وبالنسبة للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أيضا.
Anything else?